Hello viewers, I'm Rohit Khurana, your host on Intellect Digest, and today we have with us the LG Optimus G Pro, which is one of the latest offerings from LG, and this is an impressive phablet. In this video, I'm going to give you a quick hardware tour and also talk about the box contents and specifications of this phone. Let's get started. Starting with the size and form factor, the LG Optimus G Pro is a large screen device. This is a 5.5 inch display that you get here, and this is a full high definition 1080p display. This is a clear LCD display, as you can see, and it gives good viewing angles. Let me turn the brightness higher so that you can see the display more clearly, and it has nice crisp viewing angles, and the display comes out to be really sharp and very impressive. The contrast levels as well as the color reproduction comes out to be really nice and vibrant on the LG Optimus G Pro. This is one of the finest looking 5.5 inch screens that we have seen. On the front, you get a large 5.5 inch full high definition display with a scratch resistant glass coating on it, as you can see, and it is slightly chamfered towards the edges, so it gives a nice feeling when you move from edge to edge on this phone. Below the screen, you have a physical home button, a back button and a menu button, and the home button also doubles up as the LED notification. This lights up in different colors to give you messages or different indications in different colors, like the battery. When it goes low, it turns up in red color. There's a front facing 2.1 megapixel camera which is capable of high definition video recording, few sensors, standard speaker mesh. On the left hand side, you have two buttons. There is a large volume rocker in the middle, and this is a dedicated quick memo button of LG. What it does is, while you are on any screen inside any application, you can just click on it and you can make quick notes. You can highlight the areas, save it as images or in your notebook, or you can directly share it via email, etc., directly from the screen with your annotations on the top of the screen that you want to save. You can easily clear it and erase it while you are in a call. You can put it on speaker, note down the numbers, and you can make a call later on, and you can put it on the overlay mode, in which it will remain on the screen wherever you go, so you can easily turn it off as well. This is the quick memo button. On the other side, you have a power or wake up key, which is the standard key, and there's a small indent to open the back cover. On top, you have an infrared blaster. This phone also doubles up as a universal remote, so you can control your television, air conditioners, etc., using this phone. This is a 3.5 mm standard audio jack, secondary mic for noise cancellation, a metallic bezel running all around the phone, giving it a premium kind of look. On the rear, you have a 13 megapixel shooter. This is a quite capable camera with LED flash, and this is the speaker mesh. It slightly gets muffled when you put it on the flat surface, but it does a good job. The back is textured with the kind of texture which we see on the LG Nexus 4. The one we have here is white in color. You also get one in black. Removing the back panel, we see an induction kind of coil over here, which may be for wireless charging or maybe for the NFC, which is enabled on this phone. It has a 3140 mAh lithium-ion battery, which gives it the required battery juice. There is a micro SIM card slot, a micro SD card slot for expansion. It has internal memory of 16 GB, so if you need more, you can add a micro SD card and expand the memory if needed. Talking of the specification, the Optimus G Pro is powered by a 1.7 GHz quad-core processor by Qualcomm. This is a great processor and is fairly snappy. The animations that LG has put on it makes it really stunning. The kind of experience that you get is very snappy and very responsive, as you just touch the screen and it does not show any sort of lag anywhere. The applications open up with a snap, and there is no problem whatsoever when it comes to speed of the LG Optimus G Pro. There is 2 GB RAM on board, and there is 16 GB internal memory, out of which around 10.6 GB is available to the user, and you can add a memory card of up to 64 GB if you want to expand the memory of this phone. In the box, you get the in-the-ear earphones. These are good quality metallic tip in the ear earphones. You get some extra tips with it for your comfort, so you can change these tips if your ear canal size does not fit to it. And there is an inline microphone with volume control, as well as you can change the tracks, pick up the call, etc. So this is very convenient, and this is flat cable anti-tangle, and there is a 3.5 mm standard tip, so you can replace it with any other earphones that you want to use. A standard micro USB to USB cable is also included with a power charger. This is a 1.2 ampere charger, unlike the Note series which get 2 ampere charger. There is a quick start guide which is included, few other documentation within the box. You also get this phone in black color. Talking of the software, it is powered by Android Jelly Bean 4.1 right out of the box, and we are expecting that the Android Jelly Bean 4.2 or 4.3 version should also be rolling out very soon for this phone. On the software front, there are few customization, like the user interface has been customized by LG and does fairly good job. There is a video editor on board, there is Smart World application from LG, a software updater application, many other applications which come pre-installed on the LG Optimus G Pro series. You also get a remote application with which you can use it as a universal remote for your multiple devices. This is all we have on a quick unboxing and hardware tour video of the LG Optimus G Pro. If you like our video, please press the like button below for more such videos on gaming, benchmarks and performance of this phone. Stay tuned to Intellect Digest. We are coming up with a series of video on the LG Optimus G Pro. This is your host Rohit Khurana signing off. Thanks for watching.